Good afternoon to everyone and welcome to today's national webinar hosted by Department of Physics, Devan Yammal College for Women Autonomous. I would like to invite Dr. C.R. Uthra ma'am, Dean of Research, Devan Yammal College for Women, to deliver the induction.
Good afternoon and a warm welcome. Devan Yammal College for Women is an autonomous institution established in 1989, a self-financing college with a vision for women empowerment through quality education. The college occupies a sprawling area of nearly 10 acres on the Chennai Trichy Trunk Road in Viluppuram and is a unit of ES Educational Charities established in 1983 by Thiru E. Swami Kannan. The college offers 12 UG, 8 PG, 8 MPhil and 5 PhD programs encompassing arts, literature, basic science and computer science. The growth and success of the institution has gained recognition by NAC accreditation with A grade in three cycles, 2003, 2012, 2018, followed by the conferment of autonomous status in two cycles, 2009 and 2015. UGC has recognized the college with 2F and 12B status. The college is ranked 84th among all self-financing autonomous colleges of the country by the Education World. The college has received grants from DST FIST for establishment of Central Instrumentation Facility in 2018. TNSCST has sanctioned fund for 8 student projects during the last 4 years. Keeping in mind that online learning should be effective, the college encourages all the departments to conduct webinars on updated topics for the benefit of all the students. The Department of Physics is now conducting this national webinar on nonlinear dynamical systems and its applications, which will definitely motivate research. I request all the students to concentrate for one hour and make the webinar a grand success. On behalf of the college, it is an immense pleasure in welcoming you all to this webinar. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am. It is my privilege to welcome our Honorable Chief Guest, Dr. Hari Konnamarani, Associate Professor of Mathematics, National Institute of Technology, Warangal, Telangana, India. I welcome you, ma'am. Most respected, our stimulator and energetic secretary, Mr. S. Sendil Kumar, sir, ESSK Educational Charities, though he is not present here, I welcome you, sir. Respected, our dynamic registrar, Dr. E. Soundarajan, sir, ESSK Educational Charities, though he is not present here, I welcome you, sir. Respected, our motivated principal, Dr. M. Brinda, ma'am, Devan Yammal College for Women, I welcome you, ma'am. Respected vice principal, Ms. V. S. Selvi, ma'am, Devan Yammal College for Women, I welcome you, ma'am. Respected dean of research, Dr. C. R. Uthra, ma'am, Devan Yammal College for Women, I welcome you, ma'am. Faculties, colleague, my dear students and participants, good afternoon, and I would like to welcome you all to this national webinar on nonlinear dynamical systems and its application. It is my great pleasure to introduce the chief guest, Dr. Hari Ponnamarani. She completed her PhD in the Department of Mathematics, Anna University, Chennai, Tamil Nadu, India. She has 15 years teaching experience from 2006 to 2007, worked as a research professor, CFD lab, Department of Mechanical Engineering, Yonghee University, Korea, from 2008 to 2018, worked as an assistant professor of mathematics, NIT Warangal, from 2018 till date, working as an associate professor of mathematics, NIT Warangal. She has completed postdoc in various research lab in Taiwan, May 2006 to August 2006, research assistant, vortex dynamics and biomedical fluid mechanics lab, Institute of Applied Mechanics, National Taiwan University, Taiwan. January 2006 to April 2006, postdoctorate division of medical engineering research, National Health Research Institute, Taiwan. February 2003 to December 2005, postdoctorate scientific computing and cardiovascular simulation lab, Department of Engineering, Science and Ocean Engineering, National Taiwan University, Taiwan. She has published more than 70 international journals, presented more than 25 conference workshops, completed 4 PhD scholars under her guidance, received many awards and honors, member in many professional societies, European Geoscience Union, American Mathematical Society, International Association of Mathematical Physics, Indian Society for Heat and Mass Transfer, Indian Society for Mathematical Modeling and Computer Simulation, HKCS Hong Kong Computer Society, Hong Kong. She is doing research among many foreign collaborations like USA, Korea, Slovakia, Taiwan, Italy. Acted as a reviewer in various international journals such as Heat Mass Transfer, Progress in Computational Fluid Dynamics, Physics of Fluid, European Journal of Mechanics, Journal of Applied Fluid Mechanics, Journal of Energy, Heat and Mass Transfer, Annals of Biomedical Engineering, Computers and Fluid. So once again, I welcome you, ma'am. Now, I would like to invite Dr. M. Brinda, ma'am, the principal, Devani Ammal College for Women, to deliver the keynote address.
Good afternoon to all. First of all, I would like to convey my special thanks to our dynamic secretary, Mr. S. Chandil Kumar, respected chief guest, Dr. Hari Ponnamarani, associate professor, Department of Mathematics, National Institute of Technology, Warangal, Dean R. Dr. C. R. Uttara, Dr. Muniyappan, head Department of Physics, and my dear students. I welcome you all. The topic of the today's webinar is nonlinear dynamical system and its application. In nonlinear system, the change of the output is not proportional to the change of the input. The behavior of a nonlinear system is described in mathematics by a nonlinear system of equation, which is a set of simultaneous equations in which the unknown appear as variables of a polynomial degree higher than one. Nonlinear problems are of interest to engineers, biologists, mathematicians, and many other scientists because most systems are inherently nonlinear in nature. Nonlinear dynamical system describing changes in variables over time, unpredictable, contrasting with much simpler linear systems. I welcome you all to this webinar to present and discuss the topic concepts and the questions regarding the scientific approach. Thank you so much.
Thank you, madam. Now, I hand over the session to our honorable chief guest, Dr. Hari Ponnamarani.
Very good afternoon to all of you. First of all, let me congratulate Devani Amman College for Women. During this pandemic time, keeping us alive with educational motivation, especially the research, which is nonlinear and leading to chaotic analysis, turbulence also. So this is a very hot topic throughout the world. So I'm working in this field for the past nearly 20 years. So it is a very fascinating one. I will show you some of my works also at the end of my talk. I will share the simulations, how we can analyze the nature, what it tells to us, that is physics, and through the equations, through the mathematical equations, how we can analyze the variables, nonlinear variables, especially the nonlinear system of equations, as Brinda Madam has rightly pointed out. So we are going to talk about this hot topic also, I can say. Nonlinear dynamical systems and its applications. So first I will cover the linear dynamical systems. First let me talk about the dynamical systems, then only linear dynamical systems, then I will move on to the nonlinear dynamical systems. For the past more than four decades, scientists are working to understand what the dynamical systems are dealing and its applications. As I have showed here one picture, when the bottom wall of this cavity is heated up and it is moving like this, the flow is like this. So when the heat is more in comparison with the side walls temperature, then chaotic system try to appear here. So this has many applications, not only in biology, even the geomechanics also, geophysics also. Recently, there was one conference in Russia about the geocosmos theory. There also a lot of emphasis is given how the heat flow is taking place inside the earth, because the lava is present there and it is emitting so much of temperature. How the flow is taking place there? So for that one, let us start doing the differential equations. We start from the basics of differential equations, autonomous systems, phase space. These are some of the keywords I can say which are used in the differential equations. We, as I said before, we linearize the differential equations. The nonlinear differential equations are linearized with the well-known Taylor series only. All of us have come through about this Taylor series. Using the Taylor series, we assume that the continuous functions are given to us. Based on the continuous functions, the differential equations are written. And we linearize that, and then we find out the eigenvalues, not the eigenvectors. From the eigenvalues itself, we classify the critical points which are available in this differential equation and the stability of the critical point. This is the most important one. Even in the industry also, we have got some problems from BARC, Bhabha Atomic Research Center, to analyze the stability of the flow structures over there. For that one, at a critical point, whether the system is stable or unstable, that is the most important thing. The nonlinear system is stable with respect to the position and with respect to the time also we are going to analyze, especially with respect to the time, like the pendulum. So if you disturb the pendulum will come back to its original position. So we will have the stable motion there. So how to classify that one mathematically? That is what we are going to do in the part one, based on the differential equations. Coming to part two, the nonlinear systems we are going to consider there, and we are going to study about the bifurcations with respect to some examples of differential equations, and some theorems are given based on Lipinov direct method to say whether the system is asymptotically stable or not. So this also we are going to see. And we classify stationary bifurcation and dynamic bifurcation also. So stationary bifurcations, that is invariant with respect to time. So those bifurcations will not change with respect to time. And the dynamic bifurcation means, of course, the name itself tells that the changes are there with respect to time. Okay. And Pankre-Bendingson theorem. This simplifies our work with respect to the dynamic bifurcations. Okay. So these are the part two, and the Lorentz equations. It is a low dimensional model which is given in terms of ordinary differential equations. In 1963, Lorentz have given these equations. If we keep on changing the parameter value in the equation, the well-known butterfly diagram comes into picture there, like this. With respect to time, the flow is, it's not crossing, but it looks like a butterfly diagram. Same, the differential equations he has taken, simple ordinary differential equations only, and he inputted the parameters rightly, and he found this type of attractor. He called it as a strange attractor. Further, I will show my simulation, some of my work I will share with you. So in this way, I planned my lecture for 1 hour. If you have any doubts, you can ask me. So let us start with the differential equation. What is a differential equation? We all know that ordinary differential equation. If ordinary differential equation is the dependent variable and its derivative is with respect to one independent variable. Otherwise, it is said to be a partial differential equation. If it is a function of more than one independent variable, then we call it as a partial differential equation. So what a differential equation usually do? An equation that relates one or more functions and their derivatives. So this is the basic job of ordinary or partial differential equation. It consists of the functions. Ordinary means the functions are given in terms of one independent variable. Otherwise, more than one independent variable means partial differential equation. So every equation consists of the function and their derivatives. Okay. The functions generally represent physical quantities. So if you have the velocity, then the physical quantity is velocity. Otherwise, pressure, temperature, etc. Those are denoted in terms of the functions in the differential equations. So the derivatives usually represent, there means the function's rate of change. So if the function is x, dx by dt is velocity, and d squared x by dt square is acceleration, like that. The derivatives represent the rate of change of the function. The differential equation defines a relationship between these two, the functions and their rate of change. So that is given in a differential equation. Such relations are common in nature. That's what every day, every time we are encountering. Therefore, differential equations play a prominent role in engineering, physics, all engineering subjects, physics, economics, and biology also. So we can't restrict only ourselves to science and engineering. Even in economics also, this plays a critical role. Especially in share market, they use this dynamical systems very much. So study of their solution. Their solution means this function's solution, the set of functions that satisfy each equation, each ordinary differential equation or partial differential equation, and their properties of their solutions. So the properties, either quantitatively, otherwise qualitatively, we are going to analyze from the dynamical systems the qualitative structure of the solutions, and we will take over that to the partial differential equation. That means we will start with the ordinary differential equation. So the ordinary differential equation can be linear or nonlinear. Let us consider a simple example, Newton's second law of motion. So where m is the body mass, okay, the mass is proportional to the total force when mass is multiplied with the acceleration. A is the acceleration of a body. Acceleration of a body of mass m is proportional to the total force acting on it. So 1 by m as the constant of proportionality, then we can write down acceleration equal to force by m. Okay, this is the basic Newton's second law we start, and then we derive the Navier-Stokes equation, which defines the flow, how the flow takes place. Okay, so this is very simple. Newton's second law of motion gives mass into acceleration equal to F. So we can rewrite this equation in the differential form and we can solve it. Okay, only the simple differential equations are solvable by the explicit formulas, otherwise analytical solutions are available. You can see the word simple. If it is non-linear, we can't have the explicit formulas or analytical solutions to solve the given differential equation. However, many properties of solutions of a given differential equation may be determined without computing them exactly. This is the beauty of our dynamical systems. We want to study the physics behind the differential equations. So many properties of the solutions, what they are telling to us, whether they are bifurcating to some other way, otherwise they, with respect to time, the solutions are not changing. If they are not changing, whether they are stable or unstable, like so many properties we can analyze without computing them exactly. That is, even if we don't have the analytical solution to solve the differential equation, we can have the properties of the solution. That's why I put this in the red color. Often, when a closed form expression for the solutions is not available, solutions may be approximated numerically. So, in my research work and my students also doing numerical work only. So, computational fluid dynamics, my research area is computational fluid dynamics. In that area I am working. So I am getting the approximate solutions only. That is what it is written here. When the analytical solutions are not possible for the given differential equations, we go for the approximate numerical solutions. While many numerical methods have been developed to determine the solutions within the degree of accuracy. So nowadays the computers are very much available, GPUs are there. So you can have the solutions quickly, but still, if you go for the turbulent nature of the equation, then it takes weeks time to, not only weeks, months time, it depends on the nature of the problem to get the solutions. But some accuracy we can adopt and we can go for that. Differential equations has applications in the theory of dynamical systems. So first you should be very familiar with the differential equations, which puts emphasis on, as I said before, qualitative analysis of the systems. So here, instead of quantitative, qualitative analysis of the systems are given importance. So let us see what does it mean by qualitative analysis. To start with, let us consider an autonomous system. First, let us see what is the basic definition of an autonomous system. So let us consider a coupled system of the differential equation given in this form. Dx bar by dt f of equal to f of x bar, where x bar is defined in Rn. So f of x bar is an independent variable of a single variable t. Therefore, this notation d by dt is given. Otherwise, if it is more than one variable, if f is a function of more than one independent variable, then we used to write on the partial notation. Okay. So now to start with, we are considering only the ordinary differential equation dx bar by dt and equal to f of x bar. This class of system is called autonomous. So we are separating time-dependent functions, derivative quantity, time-dependent derivative quantity on one side and time-independent quantity to the other side. In this way, we used to write down the autonomous system. Once we write down the autonomous system of our differential equation, we can have a stationary solution, otherwise a solution which is a function of both space variable and also the time variable. So let us see one by one. Stationary solution, a solution which is invariant in time, a solution which is invariant in time. Now our this x bar doesn't depend on time. Therefore, what we have here, f of x bar equal to 0, f of x bar equal to 0. So we will get, after solving this, we will get the answer for x bar equal to whatever we have, we will get this one. So this type of solution is known as a stationary solution. Okay. Then if the solution, if phi of x comma t is a solution of the given differential equation, that means this solution is a function of both x and t, space variable and also a time variable, there is a chance of having a periodic orbit. Periodic orbit means there exists a closed curve C where this value is given from this function phi of x comma t, where t is varying from 0 to some time interval capital T in the phase plane. In my next slide, I will tell you what is a phase plane. Okay. Periodic function. Periodic function is, we know the definition, basic definition. So it is a repeated one. For all time, less than that time, it is not equal. That periodicity will not be ensured. So as a small example, we can see the pendulum one. So where the periodicity is ensured, you can see that. Yeah. So now you can visualize that that pendulum is moving. It is coming to its original position. So the solution is function of both. Function is, the solution is a function of both space and time. So that phi of x comma t for this pendulum equation consists of both space variable and also a time variable. That's what I want to mention here. Okay, now let us see some more terminology. Phase space. What does it mean by a phase space? Phase space is nothing but a 2D plane. So what we are doing in this 2D plane, that state of coupled system, the state of the coupled system is represented by a pair of numbers, which in turn can be represented as a point in the 2D plane called the phase space. So if we have the x and y, this is our x-axis, y-axis, then we can represent the state of the coupled system, at which state it is. If we have a stationary solution, that solution will be given as a point here. That where we are representing that one, that is known as the phase space. Associated with each pair of numbers is a pair of time derivatives. If time also involved in this coupled system, then the solution will contain x dot y dot. Usually, if you go for a flow system, this is u velocity we used to call, this is v velocity we used to call, which depend on x and y. So we can plot this u and v also with respect to x and y. That is what, where we are plotting this data, that is the phase space. This vector represents the velocity with which the state point moves through the phase space. So at some point, this velocity is here. At some other point, velocity will be there. As time increases, so the velocity will be moving. So in the pendulum, experiment also, at some point the pendulum is here, at some point the pendulum is here, at some time interval the pendulum is here. If I want to plot these points in the phase space, I have to do the solution as a point. Three points I have to put, 1, 2, and 3. 1, 2, and 3 I have to put here. So that is what they have written here. We can think of a coupled autonomous system. Now, coupled autonomous system means it consists of the time derivative also. A differential system is a flow in a phase space. So how to visualize that one? Drop a spot of ink onto the point representing the systems in the initial state. So initially, we are dropping a point of ink at some point. Then evolution of the system through the time is represented by the path that the spot traces out. So this is also a very simple experiment. So let us see how it has been done, like a school work only. So motion of the particles, it is nothing but velocity. The right side we have a hot water and this is the cold water. Tracing of the particles, tracing of the functions, velocity over the time is happening here. Yeah, so now in this experiment, you can see that in the if the fluid is hot, the velocity moves very fast of the particle. And if the fluid is cold, the velocity is less. So how mathematically we can write down this equations and we can formulate that. So phase portrait and phase plane, that's how we have seen the phase plane. And phase portrait is where we are writing the solutions. Phase portrait, representative of set of solutions, representative of set of solutions plotted as a parametric curves on the Cartesian plane. This is known as the phase portrait, tracing the path of each particular solution. So similar to the direction of the field, a phase portrait is a graphical tool to visualize how the solutions of the given system of differential equation would behave in the long run. The experiment, it has shown, the experimentally it is shown, but now we are mathematically, we are going to solve that and we are going to plot the solutions as a phase portrait in the phase plane. That's what we are doing that. So the Cartesian plane is known as the phase plane. And the path or curves traced by the solutions are known as the trajectories. So now let us start solving the equations. So equilibrium solutions are critical points, are stationary solutions, are constant solutions. All these terminologies defines the same meaning of the differential equation. So now let us consider a linear system of a differential equation dx bar by dt equal to f of x bar. Since we are considering a stationary solution, so dx bar by dt equal to 0. So if we write down this in the mathematical or matrix form, Ax bar is an equilibrium solution occurs at a solution of the system homogeneous algebraic equation. So Ax bar equal to 0. Such a system has exactly one solution located at the origin if determinant of A not equal to 0. If determinant of A equal to 0, then there is a possibility that there exists infinitely many solutions. So let us consider, we are going to consider only one solution located at the origin. So our equilibrium solution is, we are going to consider the origin by solving this equation and let us see how the solution behaves. Let us consider a very simple 2D linear system, two-dimensional linear system, two-dimensional, therefore we have two variables x and y. So let us consider this coupled system, x dot equal to ax plus by, y dot equal to cx plus dy, where a, b, c, d are some constants. As a unique critical point, that is a point where x and y are both 0 at the origin. So ax bar we have written there, ax bar we have written. So what is A now? From this, what we are getting here is, this implies A is our matrix A, B, C, D. And what is X bar here? X bar is nothing but XY. Okay. X bar is XY we have. So in this way, if we write down, to classify a critical point, first calculate the eigenvalues. Now we see we are going to consider only the matrix A, eigenvalues of the matrix. So how to find the eigenvalues of the matrix? So eigenvalues of a homogeneous system written in the matrix form. X dash equal to AX. The previous case only I have written. So X dash equal to AX, where A is a n by n matrix, X is a vector whose components are the unknown functions in the system. If we start with n equal to 1, then the system reduces to a simple linear first order ODE. If n equal to 1 means A matrix will have only one X variable here, independent variable. So X dash equal to AX. The solution we are going to write down this after solving this one, X of t equal to some constant multiplied by e to the power of at. Therefore, the general solution for n variables is given by X of t, X bar of t equal to r into e to the power of lambda t, where lambda is known as the eigenvalue. So substituting this one again and solving that, we are getting the solution. The general solution is given like this. From the this characteristic equation, using the Cayley-Hamilton theorem, if you remember, okay, which gives the characteristic equation. In order for 2 to be the solution of 1, lambda bar and r must be an eigenvalue and eigenvector of the matrix A. In this way, we find out the eigenvalues of a given matrix. Therefore, in order to solve, we first find out the eigenvalues and eigenvectors of the matrix A, and then we can form the solutions using 2. Different cases, that means the lambda can be real values, or they can be distinct eigenvalues, complex eigenvalues, or repeated eigenvalues also. So when we solve that one, there are different cases we are going to encounter. Based on the different cases, we are going to classify the critical point. What is a critical point? We are going to consider as an origin initially. Okay, let us take some example and understand further. Classification of critical points from the eigenvalues of differential equation. Again, we are considering the previous differential equation. Instead of A, B, C, D, I have written here A1, B1, A2, B2 here. So we have to assume that if determinant of A equal to 0, then infinitely many solution, and we are assuming determinant of A is not equal to 0. A is what? The coefficient of X, Y, this X and this Y. In this way, we are constructing this one. So what is the only solution here? Origin is only the critical point of this system. Okay, one has a non-trivial solution of the form. Therefore, if we have, if we solve this system, then we can see that this system has, linear system has the solution like this. X equal to A e to the power of lambda t, Y equal to B e to the power of lambda t, where lambda is the root of the quadratic equation. Which equation? From the A minus lambda I, if I write down A minus lambda I, determinant of A minus lambda equal to 0, then by substituting this one, you can see this, the determinant give rise to the quadratic equation like this. So after solving this quadratic equation, of course, we will get two eigenvalues. The eigenvalues are lambda 1, lambda 2, which are nothing but the roots of this equation. So if I rewrite that quadratic equation in this form with P as minus of lambda 1 plus lambda 2, Q equal to lambda 1 into lambda 2, then the classification of the critical point can be described in terms of the coefficients P and Q, that is in terms of the roots lambda 1, lambda 2. Okay, so it is a quadratic equation. To find out the solutions, we have the formula, isn't it? From this, I have written this, okay? So eigenvalues can be real or complex, distinct or repeated. So if the eigenvalues are distinct, real, etc., how to classify that? We can classify them as stable or unstable critical points. If all the eigenvalues have the negative real parts, you should note on that. If all the eigenvalues have the negative real part, it is classified. It means the critical point is classified as a stable critical point. If at least one of the eigenvalue is positive real part, then it is classified as a unstable critical point. apart from that, there is one more theorem which says that with respect to time, if I consider the critical point is stable, if for a positive real number r in the neighborhood, there exists a positive number r less than or equal to r in that region, such that every path which is inside the circle in that region for some initial time t equal to t naught remains inside that circle itself as t tends to infinity. So if this condition is satisfied, then the considered critical point is said to be stable. Okay, asymptotically stable, converge to the critical point always, then as t tends to infinity means, then it is said to be asymptotically stable. If it moves away from the critical point, then it is said to be unstable one. If neither of these cases satisfied, sometimes it is coming to the critical point, moving away from the critical point as time increases means, it is said to be neutrally stable. Now, classification is this one. Stability we have seen, if all eigenvalues are negative, then we say that it is a stable one. If all eigenvalues are positive, then we say it is unstable one. Classification is, there are different classifications are there, real, distinct and of same sign. If all the eigenvalues are real, distinct and of the same sign, then it is classified as a node. If under this also, stable node, unstable node, if they are negative, if the eigenvalues are negative, then it is said to be a stable node. Otherwise, if they are positive, they are said to be unstable node. Next case is real, distinct and of opposite signs. One eigenvalue is positive, other eigenvalue is negative. In such a case, we call this critical point as a saddle critical point. If there exists complex critical points, that is, it is known as a spiral focus, conjugate complex but not purely imaginary. So it should contain both real part and imaginary part like that, then it is known as a spiral one. With the real part negative, it is said to be a unstable one. With the real part negative, it is said to be a stable one. So I should put here minus sign here, okay. So further it can be classified. If a real and repeated one, real and repeated, then it is known as a star. If they are purely imaginary, then it is said to be only imaginary part is present, then the critical point is said to be a center. Okay, that is shown in a stability diagram. This plotting of node, you see here, node, spiral, center, unstable node, everything is plotted here, and this diagram is known as a stability diagram. Okay, now let us take some examples and analyze this one. Finding the linear approximation to a function at a given point. So first, let us linearize the given differential equation using the Taylor's expansion, as I said before. So what we are doing here, our equation is dx by dt equal to f of x. So we are going to perturb this by solving f of x equal to 0, this function, we will get the solution as x equal to x naught, let us say. This is our critical point, x equal to x naught is a critical point. So now what we are doing, we are little bit perturbing this one, and perturbing, how we are perturbing, giving little bit of disturbance, which is very small disturbance, that's why 2 less than 1. So now we are taking the Taylor series, f of x naught plus eta. Instead of x, we are writing x naught plus eta. Therefore, applying the Taylor series, f of x naught plus eta times differentiation of f at the point x equal to x naught plus r of eta square. So we are neglecting the higher order terms. We are left with only this one. And just now we have seen this, f of x equal to 0 get satisfied at x equal to x naught. Therefore, this term also becomes 0 and we are left with this one. We are left with only this part, last line. So from this one, we can find out the solution and we can have the eigenvalues and we can do that one. So if I solve this one, clearly shows that f of x comma y equal to 0, g of x comma y equal to 0 gives that x equal to x naught is 0 and y naught is 0. Now we are going to perturb them using the Taylor series and we are going to write down this. That procedure is given here and we are left with only these two terms, d eta x by dt equal to 3 eta x, d eta by dt equal to eta y. So the eigenvalues are lambda 1 equal to 3 and lambda 2 equal to 1. So both are positive, therefore this gives unstable critical point. Therefore it implies 0, 0 is a unstable critical point. Further, what else we can say about this one? From the table, we can observe and we can do that one. So some examples are taken here. The x dash equal to minus 2x, y dash equal to x minus 4y. After doing the same procedure, apply the Taylor series and linearize this equation and get the eigenvalues. Okay, unstable node. So we are getting here, both are positive one, that eigenvalues are positive, therefore it is classified as an unstable one. So the second example, x dash equal to x, y dash equal to minus y, gives one eigenvalue is positive, the other eigenvalue is negative, combination of both eigenvalues, therefore it is classified as saddle. When you draw this one using the MATLAB or Mathematica, any software, we have found the path lines of this one is like this. So you can have the path line. So you can see here, all the curves are converging here, converging this, they are unstable. No, so they are moving away from this critical point. So how? What is a critical point? Minus 2x equal to 0, x minus 4y equal to 0, which gives x equal to 0, y equal to 0. Therefore, origin is a, from the origin, all paths are moving away. Coming to here, the saddle is like this. Even instead of saddle, we can call this as a hyperbolic point also. Okay, like this, you can solve any differential equation. And if you plot the curves in MATLAB or Mathematica, any software, we can see such type of curves here. Very well, you can see that this is a center and this is a spiral. Either it can move towards the critical point or it move away from the critical point. Okay, unstable star also. Okay, so I have written many examples here. Due to time, I am skipping some of the examples. Okay, the next theory is about the bifurcation. In the bifurcation, which is important is with how the solution behaves as some parameter given in the differential equation changes. That is the main thing here. Okay, so the qualitative behavior of a dynamical system does not change for any small perturbation of the vector field, then the vector field is said to be structurally stable. That is, the solution is structurally stable. If you disturb the solution also, it should not change its behavior. This is second definition. Okay. So in the previous cases, we have disturbed the critical point solution and we have seen that stable or unstability. So here, stability is written with respect to the solution. Now, the second case, we are discussing about the solutions with respect to a parameter. Okay, before moving further, let us see the stability of a critical point using Lipnos direct method. The Lipnos direct method, what is given there is, this is a given differential equations to us, and we are rewriting this one as a function E denotes the total energy, and we are rewriting that Lipnos function as like this. So dou E by dou X into dx by total differentiation. How to find dE by dt? So we are writing the total differentiation like this, and if these three conditions are satisfied, then we have a special property for this. At the origin, this function should be zero. Apart from the origin, this function should be positive, and the dE by dt, this one should be negative definite. Okay, in this way, this Lipnos function is defined. Okay, if this function is defined like that, and if it satisfies all the conditions, then the critical point is said to be asymptotically stable. Okay, example is given like this. So dx by dt equal to minus 2xy, dy by dt equal to x square minus y cube. So of course, origin is a stationary point. The solution of minus 2xy equal to 0, x square minus y cube equal to 0 gives the origin is a critical point or stationary point. Now let us consider a function like this, which we got from this dx by dt and dy by dt. And you can see here the condition E of 0, 0 is 0 always. Apart from the origin, everywhere it is positive. And dE by dt is less than 0. dE by dt is less than 0 for y not equal to 0. Therefore, this is a Lipnos function. E is a Lipnos function. And the solution of the stationary point is asymptotically stable. The stationary point is asymptotically stable. So there are different bifurcations, stationary bifurcation. Let us take one example, saddle node bifurcation. That is, without time, we are going to plot this one. at the bifurcation point, a saddle and node come together. Saddle and node come together and annihilate. That is the beauty of this name, saddle node bifurcation. Both of them are occurring with respect to a parameter mu given in this differential equation. Same way, we are going to solve this differential equation. The stationary points are given by mu minus ax square equal to 0. Therefore, you are getting both positive and negative. Based on the value of mu, the stationary point behaves. If mu is negative, so automatically df here, whatever we have here, if x equal to plus or minus root mu by a. Okay, at this point, what is happening for this differential equation? That is what we are seeing here. So if the stationary point x equal to plus under root of mu by a is stable based on the value of mu, okay, x equal to minus under root of mu by a is unstable based on the value of mu. What is mu here? The parameter which is given in this equation. Okay, the next one is transcritical bifurcation. Transcritical bifurcation is defined as a fixed point exists for all values of the parameter and is never destroyed. However, such a fixed point interchanges its stability with another fixed point as the parameter is varied. That is, sometimes it becomes stable, sometimes it becomes unstable. From this one differential equation, if you solve in the same way, you can see that the stationary point x equal to 0 is stable for mu less than 0 and unstable for mu greater than 0. So if we substitute here, mu is less than 0 means here you are getting positive 1, therefore it is stable. If mu is greater than 0, it is less than 0, therefore it becomes unstable 1. You can see the colors here, blue color and this orange color, it is getting interchanged up to the origin. Sometimes it is stable, sometimes it is unstable. Okay. The other one is pitchfork bifurcation. Otherwise, we call it as symmetry breaking bifurcation also. So for that one, this is the example. Okay. Now, with respect to time, how things are changing? The whole bifurcation or dynamic bifurcation. So what is happening here? When a complex conjugate pair of eigenvalues of the linearized system at a fixed point becomes purely imaginary. When we can have a Hopf bifurcation or dynamic bifurcation means when the eigenvalues of the system are purely imaginary, at that time we will have a Hopf bifurcation. To occur Hopf bifurcation, we must have the dimension 2 or higher. Without at least dimension should be 2, that is x and y, etc., x, y, z also. In three-dimensional coordinates also you can have the Hopf bifurcation, but not in the one-dimensional case. That is what it is said. And it depends on the time. Therefore, it is known as a dynamic bifurcation. So the example is given here. So if you solve these equations in MATLAB and plot the curves, you can see that the parameter mu up to some value, we are getting the single solution. When it changes, the parameter changes to some other value, there is a closed path or periodic solution. At some point, this solution, at some point, another one like this, a periodic orbit starts its presence. So how to find out whether this periodic orbit can occur or not based on the Pendington theorem? So for the given system, if you have dou f by dou x, that together if we write down this system in this way, if this system is always positive or always negative in a certain region of the phase plane, then the system cannot have closed paths. It was proved by Pendington. And Poincaré-Pendington theorem says that if there exists a closed path of the given system in some region for the initial time t naught and remains there itself as t tends to infinity, then there exists a closed path. Otherwise, all the paths spiral towards the closed path. So we have a spiral structure, otherwise a closed path, periodic orbit structure. Okay. So these are all about the two-dimensional cases. Now let us move on to the three-dimensional systems. In the three-dimensional systems, we are going to have the quasi-periodic orbits or chaotic orbits. Chaotic or turbulence orbits. So now we are moving for the three-dimensional system. This picture I have showed initially. Now we have three-dimensional system. Therefore, three equations are written here. Here, PR denotes a Prandtl number, which is a parameter here. Dx by dt equal to PR times of y minus x, dy by dt equal to Rx minus y minus xz. You can note down here, xz is a non-linear one. Because of the multiplication of x and z, this second equation becomes non-linear. Similarly, if you see the third equation, this x and y together occurs. Therefore, this third equation also becomes non-linear. And this system of equations is given by Lorentz in 1963 to solve such type of problems. When the bottom wall is hot and the top wall is cold. So, where there occurs the circles. These are nothing but the vector lines. Streamlines are drawn here. Even we have simulated this streamlines using the finite volume method. So, if we can see such type of lines, what is a critical point and how to solve this? Okay. So, you can get the solution of these three equations by linearizing this. Okay. Linearizing this equation. So, simple properties of the Lorentz equation. These are the very beautiful equations. Nonlinearity, already I mentioned there. And it preserves the symmetry also. If you change xy to minus x and minus y, you will go back to the original equations itself. Therefore, symmetry is preserved here with respect to x and y. Volume contraction. The Lorentz system is dissipative one. That is, volumes in the phase space contract under the flow. That's what we have seen. Even after solving these equations also, you can observe this volume contraction. So, what are the basic fixed points are here? The origin is one fixed point. The same way we solve this, as we have seen in the previous cases, for all values of the parameters. Now, the Rayleigh number, we call R as a Rayleigh number. If it is always the parameters are greater than 1, if it is greater than 1, there occurs another pair of fixed points. This is the beauty of Lorentz equation. Not only the origin is a fixed point, apart from that, we have another fixed points also emerges. Okay. Now, we have solved this system in the MATLAB and we can observe the occurrence of the pitchfork bifurcation. You can see x equal to 0, this origin. From the origin, one is unstable, another solution is stable solution. So, there occurs the pitchfork bifurcation very clearly with respect to the parameter R. With respect to the parameter R, R is changing from 1 to 3 only. So, here you can see the occurrence of the pitchfork bifurcation. Further, if we linearize the Lorentz equation, that is using the Taylor series and rewrite the equation, you can find that the trace of this matrix is minus PR minus 1 is less than 0 and the determinant is PR into 1 minus R, PR into 1 minus R. For values of R greater than 1, origin is a saddle point since this value R is greater than 1 means automatically the determinant is less than 0. In this way also we can tell about the critical points, the classification of the critical point. Okay. So further we can see about the stable objects. Stable objects, otherwise they are also called as sinks, like the previous definition only. How we can call stable parts or stable objects to be those towards which all nearby trajectories converge. If they diverge, then we call them as the unstable one. Non-stable one is some of the parts doesn't converge, doesn't diverge. Okay. Now, with respect to time, dynamic bifurcation, if I do this, so he has considered these parameters are fixed by Lorentz and he published the paper. PR equal to 10, B equal to 8 by 3, R equal to 28. And with this critical point, x0, y0, z0 as 0, 1, 0. So if we solve the system of equations and if we plot the curves with respect to y and t, you can see initially the system oscillates, then aperiodic situation starts to appear. That means we cannot predict the next solution with respect to the previous solution. After an initial transient, the solution settles into a irregular oscillation. This is the one which tells that there is a chance to occurrence of the turbulent flow. Okay. So, these are the MATLAB code. Here what we did is we have plotted the same thing. X, t versus x dash, t versus x dash, t versus x also. So the aperiodic motion is showed in presence even when we have gone up to t equal to 200 also. Okay. In the phase space, if we draw this xy plane, you can see some beautiful structures here. Yz plane here. Okay. In this one, x dash z dash plane, x dash z dash values and x dash y dash values. This is a 2D structure. If we see this 2D structures, we have a feeling that the solutions are crossing each other. Okay. The trajectory appears to cross itself repeatedly, but that is not the situation. If we draw the same things in the 3D plane, you can see here the butterfly wings. The same thing is drawn in the 3D plane. You can see X, Y and Z, how beautifully that structure is caught up here. This also code also written using MATLAB 1 to solve those equations with the parameters given by Lorentz. So butterfly wing pattern appears, and this type of attractor is known as a strange attractor. So the property is trajectory of Lorentz attractor is not periodic, okay, not periodic, aperiodic. Still, there are lot of studies are going on to study about this finite dimensional systems is still unresolved. Lot of work is going on. If you take about our IIT Kanpur professor Verma's work, he concentrate only on this work of low dimensional problems. That is, Lorentz attractor is one dimensional one. If you can move further, you can have different types of attractors. I will show you in this. Okay, so this leads to a new chapter called fractal theory. So this has opened up a lot of things to study about the fractals. Okay, so the chaos or turbulence shows its presence once such type of aperiodic structure is shown its presence. This type of solutions are very sensitive to its initial conditions. Okay, so these are about the three-dimensional systems. Now I will move very quickly about my simulations, what I have done in the non-linear dynamical systems. So usually the problems are taken up from the nature. How to understand the nature? Some observational data is available. Using that data, we simulate the experimental work. And that experimental work will be validated either with the numerical work or the analytical work. Okay. So this also, what is us behind the ship? When the ship is moving in the sea, due to its velocity movement, there are wakes behind this one. How to capture this wakes using experimental one? This is known as the wind tunnel. In the wind tunnel, they used to simulate such type of experiments. Even coming to the industry also, so they are also testing this type of images, like the flow behind the car. So you can have a critical point here. So all the flow paths are converging here. So there is a lot of pressure is occurring here. And how to deal, or what are the things we can make here? They will decide. As a mathematician, my job is how to find out the critical points mathematically. Okay. So there are a lot of nonlinear systems exist in the nature. As I said before, with respect to geometry also nonlinearity can occur. Material also nonlinearity with respect to different fluids, the flow behavior is different. So different type of critical points can be observed. Okay. So these are some of the examples. So in this problem itself, the simple heat flow problem, you are heating like in the kitchen, when we are heating water also, you can see such type of regular structures. If you increase the heat, there occur some Taylor-Gautier vortices, mushroom shape of structures. Okay, so this is analyzed in very depth manner, and lot of instabilities have been observed by many scientists. It is not done by me yet, but many scientists have observed such type of structures. So skew varicose instability, you see how differently the flow behavior is occurring. And this is inside the flow behavior inside two cylinders. When the fluid is moving inside two cylinders, the concentric circle patterns have been shown up. Okay. So I have used the finite volume method, as I said before, to solve the equations. One example I want to show you is the flow in a backward facing step. Here is a step. This cross line shows the step, and the fluid is moving here. And the governing equations are like this. One is continuity equation, and the parameter is Re, P is the pressure, V is the velocity vector. So Reynolds number is here defined as a ratio between the inertial forces to viscous forces. So I am going to change the Reynolds number parameter and observe the different flow behavior. In the first figure, you can see that when the Reynolds number is 738, I am getting a single solution. After that, periodic solution starts its presence. So where are the bifurcation points for R equal to 900? This is plotted, and you can see that the bifurcation points are occurring very close to the step wall and very close to the walls, bounding walls, and to the floor also. So those plots have been done, cross sections have been taken, and you can see the critical points very well here. So based on the knowledge from the dynamical systems, we can classify this critical points and we can analyze further, okay? So these are with respect to the time. With respect to the time, the velocity u is plotted, and you can see in the phase portrait how the flow behavior is coming. It is like moving and coming back to its original position. Move from here to here, it is moving, and then again, and then again. Like that, it is coming for Reynolds number 1000. If I increase the Reynolds number to 1363, there occurs quasi-periodic solution. So frequency versus amplitude, you can see here. So the solutions can't be predicted like the smooth solutions which occurred in the previous case. Okay. So pitch for bifurcation, if I further increase 2000, then there occurs a pitch for bifurcation. This is also a time series only, nothing else has been done. Phase portrait, the solution is the three-dimensional way we have plotted this solution. Okay, and it has application in geodynamo also. We started. Okay, I will finish within 2-3 minutes. Okay. So the same heating from below and under the magnetic field, and also rotation also given here. If I take the cross sections very well, I can see the critical points. So how the behavior of the critical points, what it tells, etc., we can analyze them physically. Okay. And the industry application is corrosion, and the results are validated from the results given by the ARC. And here also the critical points are occurring. You can see very well that the due to the critical point occurring here, due to the presence of the critical point here, the rupture is taking place here, not at this point. That is what we have found that, and we have informed them. Okay. So different cross sections and critical points are shown here. So the transient results, which is the chaotic one, as by seeing this picture itself, you can compare these figures with this. How many critical points are occurring, and with respect to time, we can't predict anything. See, at 1 minute, this many critical points. 2 minutes, we can't predict the flow behavior. So this is my conclusion from the previous slides. Dynamical systems theory is an area of mathematics used to describe the behavior of complex dynamical systems. So the problems whichever we have dealt, even the biological problem also, they also show even the flow path of your drugs. That is also you can analyze using the dynamical systems. So the complex dynamical systems, usually by employing the differential equations are difference equation. You can convert the differential equations to difference equation using any method. You can solve them and get the analysis. This theory deals with the long-term qualitative behavior of dynamical system, not simply 10 seconds or 5 seconds. It moves further and we can get a lot of information. So much of the modern research is focused on the study of chaotic systems. Nowadays, how the flow behavior, wind behavior, especially for the cyclones, etc., this type of study is much needed. Even now, I have some work in water resources we are doing to analyze the flow behavior inside the earth also. So these are some of the applications which we can focus. So the George F. Simmons is the basic book to start with about the dynamical systems, differential equations with applications. Simple examples are given. Some of them I have taken from here also, the notes, because I have gone through that, I understood. I thought of sharing with you also. And other references are one from Journal of Fluid Mechanics, whichever I have shown for the backward facing step. Another one is a recent study. Okay, finite amplitude cellular convection. This is for the heating of the bottom plate and how the influence of the magnetic field also shows its presence. Okay, so only two reference papers I have showed. Apart from that, a lot of studies have been done in this area. Okay. With this quote, I want to end from Swami Vivekananda. No one was ever really taught by another. Each of us has to teach himself or herself. The external teacher offers only the suggestion which rouses the internal teacher to work to understand things. So I have done a little part, and with your interest only, you can explore this dynamical systems. Thank you. Sir, if any questions are there, I'm happy to answer. Muniyappan sir, are you there? Hello?
Ma'am? Sir, Muthuraja sir. So audible illa.
Hello sir, can you hear me?
Yes ma'am.
Thank you sir.
Okay sir.
Thank you for your wonderful presentation. I hope this is very full use for us. The session is open to all, so kindly put your question in the chat box. If you have any queries, kindly put your question in the chat box, please. Okay, the session is for now. We are going to for vote of thanks. So this is my pleasure to propose my vote of thanks for this national webinar of our department. First of all, I would like to thank for Almighty who showed the blessing and save us, especially in this quarantine time. So I would like to thank our honorable chairman sir, secretary sir, registrar sir, those who are always support to us, especially in the quarantine time. So they only encourage to us to this kind of the activity will enhance the curiosity of students for this higher level. And on behalf of our department, my gratitude also go for the principal ma'am and dean or ma'am. They are given the constant support to us. And it's my honor to thank our chief guest, Dr. Hari Pondamarani, madam, the associate professor of mathematics, National Institute of Technology. Thank you, madam. Sir, voice is getting, sir.
Yes, sir.
Sir, you can start my session, sir. Sir, is it audible?
Sir, yes, sir, audible, sir. You can continue, sir.
Okay. So it's my pleasure. And I would honor to my chief guest, actually, Dr. Hari Pondamarani, an associate professor of mathematics, National Institute of Technology, is Warangal, Telangana. So it is wonderful talks regarding the topics of nonlinear and dynamical system and its application. So the people have enjoyed this session, madam. So it's very informative and make it curious. And thank you, madam, for spending your valuable time with us. And I would like to thank for Acharya sir and colleagues, and because of this event is completed is very successful manner. And I'm very happy to thank my dear students and other participants from various institutions and colleges and university. Your peoples are supporting in the great way, and thank you once again. Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, sir. Thanks for giving me the opportunity to interact with everyone. It is wonderful for me to share my knowledge in this platform with all of you. So it hope lead to many research ideas in this topic, nonlinear dynamical systems and its applications.
Okay, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am.